solve a problem of kinetic by applying the impulse momentum method. Though already I have provided the three slides through which I am going to complete the video, but I want to make one correction, that in the next two slide one thing has been changed. So later on I will again provide these copies through the Google Chrome. Just take the new copies and don't consider the earlier three slides or the earlier three JPEG what I have sent, because only one angle has been changed, which was wrongly considered as 60 degree has been changed as 30 degree. So first I will discuss the problem, then I will share the slide with you. See, by applying the impulse momentum method, already we have solved a problem of kinetic in which we have considered only just a single body. But sometime you may get a problem which consists of a connected bodies. Connected bodies means which can be connected through string or by some other kind of links. Now, if the connection which is connecting the two bodies or three bodies are stretchable, then what will happen? When the body will be in motion, one body may move faster than the other body. As a result, the string or the rod which is connecting the bodies may be under an extra impulse. So there we need to draw separate free body for the each bodies which is in the connected body system. Then you have to write the separate impulse momentum equation for all the bodies. Then by solving those equation, we can get the unknown forces which are acting in the body. But if the connection means the string or the rod are not stretchable, then all the bodies will have the same velocity, means in same time interval they will go same displacement. So in those kind of situation, we need not to separate all the bodies. We can consider the whole combined connected body as a single case. Then we can draw the free body of the whole system. Then we can write a single equation in between the impulse and momentum. So first it is written for the cases where the connection are stretchable, means they may extend, they may elongate, they may compress. So in this kind of condition, we need to consider the impulse due to the tension or the compression acting in the connecting bodies, in the connections, means string or rod. But when the connection is not such that it may elongate or compress, we need not to consider the impulse, because the impulse will be in balanced condition. In the both sides, the same impulse will be acting, one due to the T, another due to the T. See, here you have considered a problem that determine the time required for the weight, as shown in the figure which I will show later, to attain a velocity of 9.8 meter per second. So there will be a body whose weights are shown. Now you have to find out the time after which the body will attain 9.81 meter per second velocity, not acceleration. What is the tension in the cot? You again have to separate the bodies to know the tension which is acting in the cot. You can take the coefficient of kinetic friction as 0.2 as given, and assume the pulleys are frictionless. If you see the figure, it will be much more clearer to you. So see, this is the solution where the body is shown this way. Here you can see two bodies are connected by a cord whose weight are respectively given as 2000 newton and 1800 newton, and the corresponding inclination of the planes are 30 degree and 60 degree. As here we are considering that all the bodies which are in the system are moving with the same velocity, so we need not to cut it. We need not to separate the bodies to get the unknown forces. We may consider the whole body as a single body this way. Then we can draw the free body. See, the 2000 newton is resting on a incline, is moving along an inclined plane, and the plane is not smooth. Its kinetic coefficient of friction is given as 0.2. So how many forces will be acting on it? First, its own weight will be acting downward, that is 2000 newton. Second, the reaction force which will be perpendicular in between the plane and the body, this represented by N1, and we know the frictional resistance always be acting in the tangential downward direction, and its magnitude will be the mu, coefficient of kinetic friction multiplied the normal reaction. Now if you write the summation of all forces 0 along this perpendicular direction, then you can get N1 is equal to 2000 cos 30 degree. How can I write it? As the body is not moving along this perpendicular direction, so we can write summation of forces along this perpendicular direction is 0. But we cannot write the summation of forces along this direction of string is 0, because in this direction it is moving. If you want to write it, then we can write summation of all forces acting along this line is equal to mass product acceleration. But as the body is not moving in the perpendicular direction, so we can easily write summation of forces along this is 0. From there we get the N1 is equal to this. Now we can easily find the magnitude of the frictional force. F1 is equal to mu N1. Similarly, before that we need to know how can you get the angle 30 degree here. See, this is 30. So, and the normal reaction means it is perpendicular to this plane. So this is 30. This will be 90 minus 30. Again, the weight, the line of action weight is again forming a right angle triangle with the base and with the normal reaction force. So this is again a right angle triangle, because weight always makes 90 degree with the ground. So this is 30. This is 90 minus 30 means 60. This is 90, so this will be 30. Similarly here, in the earlier copy, in the earlier slides which I have given through the Google Classroom, it was written 60 degree. It need to be corrected. See, this is 60 as mentioned here, and the weight is again making 90 degree with the ground, so this must be 30 degree, not 60 degree. Now again, we can write the summation of forces along this perpendicular direction is 0, because it is not moving along this. So by doing so, we can get N2 is equal to 1800 cos 30 degree. Again, this part has to be corrected. In the earlier case, it was 60 degree. So you need to correct it. Now we'll directly write the impulse equation. Impulse equation in the direction of motion. This body is moving along this line. So we'll write the summation of impulses along this line. See, what are the forces acting along this line? First is mu N1, that should be written negative, because it is in the opposite direction of motion, isn't it? So it should be considered negative impulse. It is trying to stop the body, not increasing the velocity. It is trying to retarding the body, so it should be negative. Again, the component of the W1 means the weight of the body is also acting in the opposite direction of motion, so its impulse also should be the negative. So here we have taken the component of W1, here we have taken the frictional force. Similarly, for the body 2, the motion is this way, and these are the forces which are acting along the direction of motion. F2 again considered negative, because it is in opposite to the motion, and the component of weight in this case is causing the movement, and it is along the direction of motion. So the component of weight which will be along this line will be W2 cos 30, which is taken positive. So it is the summation of all forces which is causing the change in momentum. If I multiply it with the unknown time that we want to find, then we will get the total impulse which is causing the change in velocity. Then we can write in the right side is equal to change in momentum by following the impulse momentum principle. Initial velocity suppose was V2 and final is suppose V1. So I can write MV1 minus MV2. Now if I put all the values which are given, or either given or has been found, then I can get the time T. So here you can see, after putting the values, we have get t equal to 117.11 second. Now one more question was there, that you have to find out the tension in the string or the cord, that you have to solve by yourself. How? Just draw the free body diagram of any of the block, either of the first block or of the second block, either for 2000 newton or for 1800 newton. Just draw a separate free body, so that we can see the tension. If I want to separate it, then I must cut the cord. If I cut the cord, I will get one more force, that will be the tension acting on the body. Now all other forces are known, only the tension is unknown. So
Here we cannot write that summation of forces along this direction is zero because it is in motion in this direction. So what can we write? Summation of impulse is equal to change in momentum. Final velocity we have already got. Final velocity is already given, that is 9.81 meter per second. And initial we can consider zero. We are considering the motion from the starting, when just the body has started to move. So we can write the impulse along this line is equal to minus W1 sin 30 minus F1, and T will be in the upward direction. So plus T multiplied the T. T means the time. Already we have got 117 point some second. That will be equal to change in momentum. That is MV1 in place of V1 will write 9.81 meter per second, and in place of V2 will write 0 initial velocity. From there we will get the unknown tension capital T.